Gentlemen, have you ever questioned yourself while overhauling the fuel pumps, either of the main engine or of the generator engines? The plunger has got a helical cut on the top for the area where the fuel delivery is controlled. It is very much understood that the helical cut will affect the timing of the injection of the fuel into the cylinder. But why the cut is given like that? The simple answer to this is that as we will see in the diagram, that in the lower loads or in the lower RPMs, and the time which it gets to burn in the combustion space is more, there it is delayed, and during the higher loads or during when the engine RPM is high or the quantity of the fuel is high, then by the time the fuel gets ready, it ignites and expands, it will take a lot of time. So therefore, the advancement is given in the higher loads, so that by the time it ignites, it will have reached the same time as when it was igniting in the lower loads. So more or less the same timing of expansion is maintained throughout. And higher loads, an extra time is given for it to get ready in advance and expand almost at the same time. That is why the helical cut is given on the plunger even in the generator engines. And this is also made in the main engine fuel pump plunger. Gentlemen, this is the rough sketch of the piston rod, thrust bearing, conducting rod and the web. And this is the combustion space. This is for the normal combustion conditions. That means, if we look at the crank angle here, after TDC, after going to a certain angle, the expansion has started. So this is the normal condition of the firing. What if the timings are changed? Say for example, the timing is too early. So this would be the rough sketch of this. Then the combustion has already finished too early, and you can see that combustion finish termination of the combustion and beginning of the expansion is taking place too early. That means the connecting rod is almost vertical. That means the load on the main bearing and all bearings, the vertical load on the all the bearings will be too high. And moreover, we need torque out of the combustion beam. So the for the proper torque, the work position should be little bit more than the little bit after the TDC, just like here. That is why in the low RPM the beginning of the injection is late, so that the combustion and the expansion takes place after that. So the combustion will be, the expansion will be around here. Which is the normal procedure for this for getting better torque instead of getting the unwanted vertical load on the bearings. What if the timing was kept same for the higher RPMs? What will happen is that by the time if this shape is not made, the fuel will take more time because it is having very less time because the engine is running at a very high RPM. So for the fuel to mix and to burn and to expand, it will take much more angle. Say by the time it expands, the crank valve will have to travel to about nearly the right angle, that means nearly 90 degrees. So the expansion will take place from this point. So there is a loss of work from this to this. That is why for the higher RPM it has to be advanced, and for the lower RPM it has to be retarded. That is why this helical cut is given here.